Really?
Yeah. So anyway, we were going to discuss it. After Diane comes in, Diane has a few things to plug. Now, normally, I have Diane on the show way too much. I really do. Let's be honest.
Bad. There are very, very
prominent
entertainers who call all the time and ask to be on this show.
And I say no.
I won't mention any names.
Yeah.
Haven't even been on in a long time.
Right. They're guys, though.
No.
A lot of them are guys.
Most of them are guys.
All of them are guys. But she does something to me because as a young man, I always liked Price is Right. And I'd love to nail her. So the idea that something could happen. So let's bring in Diane.
Oh, she's here.
Yeah, Diane's here.
Oh, I didn't know.
Oh, yeah.
This was a preliminary.
No preliminary. Let's get right to it.
Okay.
I always think something's going to happen between us. That's why I always have her in.
Well, let's see.
How much can happen in the studio, though, with Fred and Jackie in here?
Oh, anything could happen if you were wild enough.
Let me soak you in. Hold on.
You think that would hit at Jackie?
Nice dress. Mini dress.
Whoa.
Why are you wearing stockings?
Is he afraid to come in?
Can you go in the ladies' room and take off your stockings? You won't? Come on. What? Underneath your stockings?
Well, no. Pantyhose,
right? Now you say you don't wear panties? Here it is, in the Skin magazine.
No,
they got a shot looking up your dress. Yeah, but you're, I mean, there's a sheer. I can see everything.
But the thing is,
you
would ever expect that some photographer would come in with a camera down here shooting real fast.
Some guy.
You think I was going to pose for some?
Diane put her feet up on a dress. I mean, put her feet up on a desk. And she's wearing a mini skirt.
And it happens to all of us. We get.
And there's a picture of her private parts.
Oh,
right here. That's your private area, right there. Blown up. That's it.
Yeah.
It's cute. You have the cutest private part. So cute. I'm not bad. You loved it.
Well, thank you very much. But I saw the one of Robin.
I don't even
want to
talk about it, do you?
And there's Robin on the next page.
And when the light, when this
that's right. Yeah.
I don't care what you're wearing.
Yeah, all of a sudden.
Yeah, like nudity.
Look at you. I see your private parts.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, look at that. How cute.
Like you had
in such a sex fantasy about you last night. What we were doing was so wrong.
Oh.
It was, what are you wearing? What is that in your hair?
She's always had that in her hair.
Those little beads.
I like that. 5 years.
Let me tug on that. Let me drag you across the floor with that. look how you shave. You know, this is one of those rare instances where a woman puts her feet up on a desk, she's wearing a miniskirt, and they snap the picture, and they see right up the dress.
The photographer probably didn't know he had that either.
No. Oh, I think she knew what she was doing. Diane knew what she was doing.
You know what? They had I don't want to even give them credit. There was a magazine out about last year.
Yeah.
They had Elizabeth Taylor, Sophia Loren,
right.
Every major star
right.
Getting out of a car or getting. And if you've got one of these handheld things that are shooting, you're going to eventually get one shot where you'll get, and then they'll blow it up to like 8x10.
Right.
You know?
Oh, come on. I see how groomed you are and everything.
Well, of course, I'm very, very...
Very well groomed. You must shave. Tell me about your shaving habits. You go in the shower.
Shave?
Yeah, you shave, right?
Shaving?
Yeah.
No.
You don't? You're that fair down there?
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta have you. You're telling me you don't groom at all?
Well, I don't... I mean, I groom my body.
But you don't you don't have a razor blade in the shower? And,
no.
Really?
No waxing.
You have to...
I'm
God.
I have no hair.
Oh, wait a second. Let me feel this more.
I have no hair on my body.
Do you shave your legs?
Actually, I don't have to.
Really?
Yes.
That's natural, what I'm seeing underneath you?
Well, Robin.
I once had a girl like you in high school.
You're good.
I had a natural blonde. I had a natural blonde in high school. And she, like you, had very little hair.
You can remember back that far.
And that turned me on.
People always said, you know, you're like a hairless wonder, you know.
So
you
my,
think
it was bad. So really weird. I had this dream last night. Not a dream. I was laying in bed, relaxing myself.
Be nice to Allison.
Yeah, forget Allison. Allison's from Allison. I have to have love.
I got...
What is that?
love on my screen.
Yeah, good. You're taking that jacket off in a minute. So wait a second. So I'm laying in bed. I swear to God, this is true. So I was thinking that you were coming in today, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, somehow I ended up at your hotel room, which is impossible because I don't know how I would end up at her hotel room. But it was under the premise like I had to do an interview with her or something, or I had to do something.
Okay.
She had a business proposition. She wanted to talk to me about it.
You wind up at the hotel.
Yeah, you know, you made up some kind of weird...
Oh, so it wasn't your idea, it was hers.
Okay,
yeah.
Yeah. I'm negotiating to do a talk show for Playboy. So,
right.
So you came to, and
right.
I'm trying to talk you into being my first guest.
Right, and you just said to me, Howard, please stop by for 10 minutes because I really want
to talk to you.
Yeah, which is fine, and I said, hey, you know, is it all business? And absolutely, you know, I really need advice, and if you just give me 10 minutes of your time.
Yeah.
And I go, okay, why not? Diane, she's always been a friend, and a good friend of the show.
Well, I'm glad to see that you're returning favors, that you're going to go give her 10 minutes of your time.
Yeah, I mean, come on. Plus, she's pretty and everything. And I figured, hey, why not? I'll go over. So I go over, right? And then she, because I'm married, she takes over.
And here you go. It's your rape fantasy.
Yeah. I know. And then all of a sudden she says, you know, hey, listen, Howard, I know that you're married and stuff and how guilty you'll feel and all that, but you want me, don't you? And I go, yeah, I really want you, babe. All of a sudden, like, her hands are up above her head.
Hmm?
Like, you know, like when something like Jesus is, like, you know, like...
I did it.
Your hands are up and they're crossed and you're up there and you're naked against the wall.
Oh, you mean she's standing against the wall like that?
Naked. And I'm...
Do you have a camera?
And then I say to her, and because I'm so paranoid, even in my fantasy, I go to her, listen, I want to do something special to you. So do you have any of that I could possibly bring home to my wife?
Even in your fantasy.
Yeah, even in my fantasy, I'm checking her. And I go, well, maybe we should wait 3 days. I'll have a doctor check you out.
I have not dated in a year and 8 months.
Really? And you don't have anything? You don't have herpes or anything?
No.
Okay, because I'm really clean. I don't really want to get any of that.
But I don't know what's happening in my life, but I haven't dated anybody for a year and 8 months.
Wow, you must be so horny. Are you really horny?
Well...
you're ready.
No, that has nothing to
do with it. So anyway, I'm running through a checklist. I go, you are horny. Okay. Come on, why don't you be honest and say you're horny?
Well,
you're horny. You can be honest.
You're human.
You have needs.
I have needs.
Come over here. Let me massage you. Come on over. Let's stop fooling around. Let's have some massage time together.
But women have ways of taking care of things that they don't have.
Oh, yeah? You got a vibrator or something? Really?
Right.
You have one, huh?
This show did last quite a little longer.
Yeah.
There was this woman that
from
San Francisco, and she had all these
vibrators?
Sexual
toys.
And
did you get horny?
You had no idea those things existed, huh?
She knows. She's not as innocent as she makes it out to be.
I didn't know about this one, and the audience was so taken with it that she was giving them all out to the audience, and I went to it. I said, don't you have any left?
Oh, really? Then did you get one?
No, she gave them all away. She's like, I didn't bring it.
Well, you are horny.
What the world?
Believe me, however horny you are, Robin is 10 times hornier.
It's like you can wear it all day.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. She said she had it on.
You sat around all day?
No, it goes around your waist, and I guess.
You wear it all day, and when you're at work and stuff.
Everyone can actually.
Really?
It doesn't make a lot of noise.
It doesn't make noise.
It just is.
It was overwhelming.
Oh, you just
control it. You hold it in front. It's just control in your pocket, right? And you can vibrate it while you're at work and stuff.
Oh!
See what I would do? I would hook you up to that, and then I would just start, and you'd be tied up to the bed.
What are we talking about?
And then you would beg me to stop, and I wouldn't, and I'd keep vibrating you.
I keep looking at Rob.
Yeah, Rob's hornier than you are. What are you talking about, Rob? Gee, you know.
Yeah, we have this discussion all the time.
Robin has a vibrator with Bob Barker's face on it.
Yeah, I'm looking for somebody to tie it up with.
Yeah.
Give me
one satisfied little minky. No.
Would I be okay the next day, though?
Oh, you could walk. You'd be walking around bowling. You walk around like there was a bowling ball between your legs. You would go nuts. I would do everything too. So anyway, so last night I'm laying in bed.
Okay. You know, this is before we found out about this new toy.
Yeah, it took me napkins in the bedroom and everything.
Napkins?
Yeah, you know.
Oh, you mean really at home?
Yeah, my home last night.
I thought we were building the fantasy.
No, this was a fantasy. This is what I was doing it to. Oh, I was doing it to you last night.
You bet you were in a hotel.
You know, I have my tricks of anyone when I'm laying in that bed, and I chose you. You know how sick that is? That's all I want is you.
Sick?
Look at you. Can you take off your jacket, please?
No.
Oh, come on.
What is toxic? You're gonna
oh, please, tease me.
There's something.
Don't tease me. There really isn't. Let me see how you look.
What?
I can't see how you look.
Ta-da.
Oh, man.
I didn't show
After
you
I was
you.
Done with you.
I didn't show you my top.
You'd be covered
I
mean, in,
not my
you would be co- that top would be covered in candle wax. And I don't mean candle wax. Anyway, so I'm laying in bed this and I'm thinking about it. So then I end up in your hotel and you're naked against the wall and your arms are up in the air. And I'm taking you, and I'm doing, first they check you out, and you got chlamydia, no, I don't have chlamydia, you have paramecium, no, I don't have paramecium, whatever it is.
Paramecium.
Yeah, I know a guy who had that, paramecium.
What is that?
I don't know. I don't want any
what
disease.
What was the other one?
Chlamydia?
Yeah. Oh, well, it sounds
I don't know. But I know guys who've had that, and girls.
Well, guys give it to girls. They don't know they have it.
Jungle rot.
Well,
yeah, I haven't had sex in 20 years, so I'm free of all
this. You might have been walking around like a carrier all this time.
Maybe.
Oh, God.
I don't think so.
Jungle rot, we have jungle.
You like that. So anyway, listen to me. Stop laughing so much. You're giggling like a teenager. That's exactly what happened.
I'm a child woman.
You're a child woman.
I can't help that.
I know that.
I tried to change it.
I know it about you. What's that? It's a telephone.
No,
well, you're busy from love.
Because
of the different markets and cities that we're on.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm impressed.
That has to impress a woman.
I'm very impressed with you.
Really?
I'm always in love.
Can I just rub your backside? Please, I just massage it. Come over here to my lap. No, I'll say. Come on, give me a break. I have to touch you. What? What's the big deal? You don't have a boyfriend.
Let me get a little wallet. You know how you want to put on those TV shows?
What's the big deal?
Maybe you can
really?
Keep the tension going.
You know you want it. And you know I want it. What's the difference? We're two adults. Why not have fun?
Well, if you weren't married, it would be really cool.
I'm not married. I'm only married by the guys of the church.
In the eyes of the church.
That's it. Mentally, I'm not married right now. I'm weak. Take advantage of it.
He's trying to practice this new thing where he crosses the line into Manhattan and he's no longer married.
I thought about it. I think once I come to work in this building, I'm not married. Because I'm a different guy, right, Robin?
What did Allison say? Allison said you are different.
Yeah, I don't agree with Allison's view of it. She says that I'm married no matter where I am.
Well, I think she's making
it. Oh, please.
But I mean, I'm crazy about you.
I'm crazy about you.
I think you're great.
Is it possible to be...
I like Allison.
Yeah, sure.
No, I've seen her.
Is it possible to be in love with two women at the same time, Robin?
Oh, I'm sure you can be in love with many. That's where Menage a Trois comes
in. I'm in love with you, and I'm in love with Allison. And I might be in love with you more.
Howard, you're going to get in such trouble.
I don't care. I'm already in trouble.
I'll go all the way.
I'm letting my feelings be known to you.
Oh, well,
I have to be honest with you. I'm in love with you. I don't like you. I'm in love with you. You're perfect for me. You're the perfect woman for me. I know we can be happy together. We'll have fun. We'll watch movies in bed together.
Oh, yeah.
Eat Chinese food together.
Yeah, we're sort of almost reclusive hermitizers.
Exactly. Gary, get in here. Get a priest and get someone to marry us.
So you're going to be a bigamist now.
Yeah, I'm going to marry you right now. Would you be my wife?
Yes,
you would. You accept?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
Well, here's my ring.
You got long hair.
Right.
Tall.
And I got a radio show. Exactly.
This is another thing. You think that people like you because you are successful. That's not true.
Really? You would like me even if I was a bum?
Yeah.
Oh, please.
Diane, you've never seen him off the radio.
Yeah, it's an ugly show.
It's very fine.
Hey, Diane, do you mind bending over? It's time for the honeymoon. Come over here. It's time for our honeymoon. We've been married.
And work real hard to come in here.
No, this is the way I always look.
Well, then
this is my natural. In fact, I could look a lot better if I spruced up for you.
No. You don't know about the times at home when he doesn't even shower and just lays there.
Oh, shut up. No, that's only because I've been married for a long time. For you, I shower every day. I shower every 3 minutes.
You shower together?
Oh, yeah. I soak you up. I would do, we would probably take an hour-long shower. It would take an hour. You know what it would be? You'd be in a marble shower.
Oh, hello.
It'd be a little, like a place to sit down. And while the shower was going, hot and steamy, and then you would just sit back, close your eyes, and I would be on my knees, and something would happen to you where you would just, it would be all centered on you. I'm that kind of guy. I care about a woman's pleasure.
I love that.
Oh, yeah.
But I care about your pleasure, too.
Well, hey, nothing wrong with that.
You'll sit down.
Right. Yeah. I'll sit down, you can pleasure me.
That's true. Or
you'll
stand up.
Let me tell you, whatever you want, baby.
He's all right.
I'll bring a Chinese midget in there with us just to massage your ass. Let me tell you something.
What are you doing?
I have to let my feelings out.
I'm getting to know you so well that I'm opening up.
I know, we're opening up. This is crazy. This is devilish.
I only reserve.
This is crazy. This is crazy, Robin.
It is crazy.
What's going on here? This is crazy.
It's like we're becoming like really good friends.
Now we're past just acquaintances. Now we're almost married. We're buddies. The only thing left to do is to get physically close. Am I correct?
I don't know if you should go over that line.
That's right.
Yeah, I think we could end up destroying.
So I went over to your hotel room last night, and then your hands were over your head, and then I did something to you. I still had my clothes on while I did it to you. You were completely naked, and I did it, and you were so happy.
I had my hands on your shirt.
Yeah, you were, and then we did everything. That was just the first go round. Yeah. I said the meeting lasted longer than 10 minutes. Probably a lesbian, probably hates my guts.
No.
You had a foot up on each. We had two chairs, and you had a foot up on each chair.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you were very open to me. Let's put it that way. You were very open to suggestion. You were totally liberated. You were like not embarrassed.
I understand it now. I'm telling you,
you didn't even know, and then you were just getting like dizzy and passing out, and you were from the ecstasy.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was great.
And then what we do later?
Later? Oh, okay. What do you mean, what do we do later?
Well
that
well,
one
he turned over and went,
yeah. Hey, Robin, I get the color. It was beautiful.
You should want something,
We had sex, and we did something wild.
That was good.
You were wild, I was wild. I didn't even care if you were wild. I was wild.
Yeah.
Oh, we did it all. We even did the handkerchief trick.
Are you
what?
Whoa. Are you just a woman, pleasing you?
Are you kidding?
Oh, come on. Of course, but I like
but,
to...
I mean, you...
I like to see... You know what pleases me?
I love to give to a woman.
But you know what pleases me?
What?
Watching you squirm around and seeing you getting turned on.
Nice.
That really turns me on.
I know I'm
I'd rather see, you know what? I'd rather see this go on our session like 2 or 3 hours of constant teasing. Yes. You're a bad little bitch. We have fun. Hey, what's 73 minus 4?
73 minus 4, I'm not telling you.
Yeah, oh, you.
You were squirming like a slug.
Oh.
No, I'm telling you. So there'll be no physical contact between us? Here's what I suggest we do right now.
I'm just afraid at this point.
Are you afraid to have physical contact with me?
Well, it's your marriage that's getting in the way of us.
It's really not a marriage in the typical sense.
You're just not brother and sister.
Yeah, my wife is almost like a sister to me. No, I don't want to fuck Allison. Please
you should talk to her.
Let me suggest this, a way of us getting to know each other. You come over here. I slip off that jacket, okay? You're in your tube top or whatever that is. What is that, leotard?
It's a leotard.
All right. I put my hands on your thighs. I slip off your stockings.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
You sit on my lap.
Mm-hmm.
Your jacket is off, and I give you a back rub, an innocent back rub. And that's as far as it goes. What do you think?
I'd grab you out of here so fast.
Really?
No.
You want to lie?
He doesn't want to be frustrated by you.
You think I'm going to get you? Let me get all going.
I won't go anywhere. I won't go anywhere near your baby machine. I will not be anywhere near your baby machine.
Sold it for 1 year and 9 months. He's going to do that to me.
Right. Yeah.
So, Diane, what are you saying? I can't do that to you? You're not going to allow me that pleasure?
Well,
Yeah, it would be too.
It would be too what? Would it really? It would be too sensual?
Well, I yeah.
Not for me, it wouldn't.
You can handle it. You can handle it.